Crindle Cracks, Chapter 26. Winston got dressed and went to the zoo. When he told them about the missing crocodile, they instructed him to go and to never come back. He would never be allowed to look after animals again. Winston went home and put his uniform in a suitcase under his bed. Then he sat at the kitchen table in his pyjama bottoms and a white vest and said, "I want some toast." Wendy said, "Why don't you go out? I thought you said you had a friend." "I was wrong," said Winston. "It's too dangerous having a friend. I shouldn't have interfered. I'm not going to interfere with anything from now on." A few days later, Wendy gave birth to a son. "What shall we call him?" Wendy asked Winston. "I don't mind," he replied. "But you must have a preference." I don't want to interfere, he said. "Then I'll call him Ruskin," Wendy said. Chapter 27. After he'd finished telling his story, Winston fell asleep. Ruskin stared at his dad. He looked at the wrinkles around his eyes and the grey hairs already appearing in his thinning hair. He looked at the dirt beneath his dad's fingernails and the holes in his white vest. He looked at how small his dad was, how thin his arms were, how knobbly his knees. And the more he looked, the harder he found it to believe that this man was responsible for Crindle Cracks. The ticking of the clock on the mantelpiece sounded very loud. Ruskin glanced at the clock. It was just gone midnight. Way past Ruskin's bedtime, Ruskin helped his dad to his feet, took him upstairs and put him to bed. Once Ruskin was in his own room, he looked out of the window down the length of Lizard Street. He looked at Corky's house. How could he talk to Corky again? How could he be friends with Corky when his own dad, Winston Splinter, had been responsible for Corky's white hair and limp? And at the end of the street, the pub sign swung in the breeze. Ruskin peered at the sign. Yes! Now he could see it wasn't a dragon with a penny in its mouth at all. It was a crocodile, a baby crocodile. The baby crocodile had been taken from the zoo and escaped to the sewers. "Eek!" went the sign. To Ruskin, it sounded like the most terrible noise in the world.